Yo, 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 what's good with it? Welcome back, family. This is Accounting for Beginners. And what number are we gonna do today? We're gonna do 38. 38. Can you believe it? Can you feel it? Can you feel the heat? Ooh-wee! Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back. You knew it. This one's huge. This one, we're gonna do retained earnings in 38. Welcome back. If this is your first time, you're like, what's going on here? What is going on? I am CPA Strength. I am the strongest CPA in Florida. Playlist right here. It is a link. It is the card to the best accounting playlist in the world on the internet. Right here. Right here. You, me, let's go. Let's do this, all right? Come on, man. We're going to do... CPA Strength, what are you gonna do today? I'm gonna do retained earnings. I feel like doing them retained earnings. If you haven't watched 37, you might wanna go watch 37. That was on net income. And that 37 directly, the net income directly carries over into the retained earnings. So let's get into this, man. Let's do some retained earnings. As I was setting up for this morning, I was like, because I had a problem with retained earnings. I used to abbreviate it into RE because all the teachers used to put on the board, RE, RE. So I was always like, rerun, rerun, and like what's happening, and it was just a mess. I was writing up on this board how I wanted to try to explain retained earnings, and I was like, this just seems too easy. I opened my book and looked at retained earnings. Let's see. Is that the definition right here? Net income retained in the business called retained earnings. For real now? For real now? So retained earnings, definition in the book, as you just saw, is net income retained in the business. What is retained? Kept in, kept in. I had $20, I spent 10, I retained $10. They also have things called like retaining walls, and that keeps in like dirt. I don't know, retainers, does that keep in your teeth? But it's what you got left, it's retained. So retained earnings. Now this is also my mapping system, DCAler. If you don't know it, go back. This has helped thousands of people at this point pass their accounting classes. DCAler. Debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue, in the positive forms. The definition of retained earnings is net income retained in the business. Okay. Stop, pause, let's do retained earnings. Balance sheet, 12/31. This is the balance sheet right here. Assets equal liabilities plus equity. As you know, like journal, debits equal credits, everything, you know, equals, equals, equals. It's one of the things I like about accounting, I love about accounting, is that everything equals and you can check your work and it makes sense. A 12/31/16 balance sheet. This was the balance sheet at the end of AFB 37 when we did net income. The 12/31/16. So this is the last day of the year. Now, accompanying this 12/31/6, the last day of the year balance sheet, is an income statement for the entire year, January 1st through December 31st. That would be the income statement with that net income statement that I don't have here, had a net income of 1,000. So we learned net income from the income state transfers over to the balance sheet. And then let's look at our balance sheet at 12/31/16. We have cash of $1,000. That's our asset. Assets equal. A lot of times it'll be different pages as well. Like this would, assets will be on the first page, and then the liabilities and equities will be on the second page. So you can kind of just look at them like, you know, oh, this one page is assets. So, you know, whatever, this page equals this page, which is liabilities and equity. So sometimes it's pages, it has to equal. So you had assets of $1,000 on the 12/31/16 balance sheet, last day of the year. it has to equal liabilities and equity. We don't have any liabilities in the balance sheet, and the only equity we have is net income of $1,000. So that equals assets equal 1,000, liabilities plus equity equals 1,000. So we're good. Now that is the last day. So you're like, dude, this is retained earnings. How are we gonna get retained earnings? Well, it's really, really, really pretty easy, simple. I mean, the only thing that changes is we go one day. So 12/31, you're at New Year's partying. You know, next day, 01/01/17, the very next day. For a balance sheet, it's just another day, what happened at this day. But it's the start of a new period. It's the start of a new year. So you're also gonna have whatever income statement you had before, that's old. That's the 2016 income statement. Now we're starting with a brand new for 1/1/17, for January 1st, 2017, the first day in 2017, you're gonna start with a new income statement, but simply net income just transfers over to retained earnings. That's really all it does. So that's all that retained earnings is. It's just whatever net income was on the last day of the period, or 12/31/16, the last day of the year, you had net income of $1,000. The very next day, you have this net income, you have got $1,000 net income, you're like, yes, I got $1,000 net income, I made $1,000 this year. Cool. Well, now we're on a whole new year. So now we have to be able to look on the balance sheet, that's why it's in the top, we have to look real fast, how you're doing this year. Like with 2 seconds, I can look at a balance sheet and go, how you doing this year? And that's because of the new, there's gonna be a new net income on the new income statement and a new balance sheet. So this old net income transfers over to retained earnings. It's retained. Net income retained in the business. That was retained earnings, people. Just get started. Less think, more do. Boom.